force was there, means pressure was there, cos theta. So finally we can say that this one is nothing but 0 to our theta initial p r d theta. So if we can bifurcate, is the force will come, the force that is separating the both the rolls, power rolls, we can say that this one is an integration of 0 to theta n, whatever be the pressure is there, after r d theta plus the integration theta n to theta initial, this one is a p before r d theta. So this one is related to the force that separate the roll, or this one is the thrust at the bearing. Now the next one is driving torque and power. So driving power is required to overcome the torque that is exerted on the roll by the interfacial friction. So we can say this one is a torque exerted on the roll by the interfacial friction force. Interfacial friction force. And corresponding to, already we have taken the width unit, this torque would be given by 0 to theta I mu into p into r square d theta, or this may be minus before. So this one is a 0, theta n is there, mu p is there, and this p is after so already we have given that theta n to theta I mu p, this one is for the before. R square d theta. So the driving torque would be given by the expression what you have observed it now. So what would be the power loss? that will be equal to the T omega. So the total power would be nothing but we can say as T into omega. This is the roll power that is required. The power, now we are considering here the power. Power is nothing but this is T into omega, whatever the torque is there, that is given by the power. For the power, we have to multiply the angular velocity, or that is 2 pi n. Now, we are taking, so up to now what we have discussed whatever the neutral zone is there, how to get the neutral zone, there would be a peak, and after that we have gone for the torque required and the power loss. On that basis we have to find, now let us go for the numerical numerical problem. So how to get a numerical problem to be solved? Now again take a numerical problem on the screen. So here on the screen you can see that according to our analysis the cross section of the strip is 150 mm into the 6 mm is there. It is rolled with the 20% reduction of the area and the diameter of the roll is 400 mm. Before and after the shear yield stress of the strip, material is 0.35 kilonewton per meter square and 0.4 kilonewton per mm square. So already you are knowing that the yield strength before the cold working and after the cold working it changes. So here let this one is, first one is 0.35 kilonewton per mm square, another one is 0.4 kilonewton per mm square. The coefficient of friction that would be taken as 0.1, we have already discussed. For cold rolling the coefficient of a friction is 0.1. So here what we have to find finally, the first we have to find the final strip thickness, that is easy based on the thickness before, and the 20% is already given to us. On that basis we can find the thickness. After that the average shear yield stress during the process. For the average shear yield stress we have to take the final and initial, add it, and after that divided it by the 2. Simply we are taking the average of both the values to get the shear yield stress. The angle subtended by the deformation zone at the roll center, and final question is the location of the neutral point. This one is a very important. So for that what would be our how to get the analysis. For the analysis, for the first one that has been given as T final, it has been asked for the T final. So the T final is equal to nothing but we can say 0.8, means 20% reduction is there, So rest is 0.8 of T initial. So for the first one, it is easy for us to find the thickness. So this one is nothing but 0.8. So this would be equal to our 4.8 mm. So initial thickness is 6 mm and final is our 4.8. For the second one, already we have discussed is there the average shear yield stress during the process is less than the final one. So in that case we are taking this shear yield stress as K initial plus shear yield stress at the final by 2. So finally, if you add the shear yield stress, you will get (0.75/2 kN/mm²), or simply we can say as 0.375 kN/mm². For the third one, theta initial, theta that the angle subtended by the strip with the interface, that would be given by T initial minus T final upon whatever the roll radius is there. So here if we keep the values, this would be under root of 6 - 4.8/200. This would be in radian, and finally this is 0.0 radian. The important is the fourth one, that we have to find theta n. It can be calculated by the equation already we are knowing. So this, before that we have to find lambda n, and this one is given by 1/2 is of 1/μ log of T final upon T initial plus lambda I. The expression, already we are aware with the expression, and here this lambda I, this would be nothing but we can say 2 under root whatever with the radius is there upon T final. That is a tan inverse r upon t final. Just put the all the values of r, t final. Already the theta initial is known to us. So, we have lambda I, and this lambda I, when you calculate, you will put the value. So, this will come near about, you can say, 5.99. So, in this way, we can say that lambda n is equal to near about 1.88. So, the value of theta n, we have to find the theta n. For the theta n, we have to put this value in t final by r tan of lambda n by 2 under root of t final upon r. So, if we put the value here in t final, already we have calculated